New at 11, when record flooding struck in late December, most people assumed the cause was the record rainfall that preceded it.
However, Fox 2 meteorologist Chris Higgins is here to tell us why there is much more to than just heavy rain. Chris.
Yeah, no doubt the heavy rain had a lot to do with it. After all, you can't have flooding without having a whole heck of a lot of rainfall, a lot of water to get that big of flooding. But to look at the root cause of why that flooding was so bad, you literally need to get down to the roots.
Native plants were the ones that were here before all the settlers from the old world arrived.
But those native grasses are largely gone. The landscape of rural Missouri that we see today is nothing like it was 200 years ago.
And they changed things so that they could live like they did back in Europe, the way they knew how to live.
That meant stripping native warm season plants from the fields to make way for farmland. A practice that has had long-lasting and unforeseen consequences.
The roots from the warm season plants go 5 to 15 feet deep. That's extremely significant for the activity and the vigor of a field. You've got soil that's capable of retaining lots of water.
But without those native plants and their deep root systems, heavy rain quickly turns to runoff.
If you have prairies restored or reestablished in critical landscape positions over the landscape, chances are we will have massive absorption of stormwater into the soil and less water getting into streams and rivers, avoiding or reducing the threats of flooding.
That's one of several theories being tested by Dr. Shabu Joes and a team of scientists from Mizzou at this farm northwest of Kirksville.
If you have runoff, well, it's not just the soil that you are losing along with that water. It's all the chemicals that we put into the soil. And eventually, all the water will be flushed and will reach the Gulf of Mexico, and it creates massive hypoxic zones, killing fish and all kinds of marine life.
Dr. Joes wants to see if even limited prairie restoration can filter out those harmful chemicals, while at the same time holding back significant amounts of potential floodwater. Early results are positive, but one negative is the cost.
I think all farmers tend to be conservationists. They want to be conservationists.
Rudy Raceline owns the farm where the study is being conducted. He and his son are looking for ways to make prairie restoration profitable for farmers.
But they've got kids to raise, they've got college to pay for, they've got tractors and equipment to pay for, and so they use as much of their land as they possibly can to produce the commodities that currently are on the marketplace.
One of the more promising possibilities is to combine prairie grass with pig manure. As the mixture decomposes, natural gas is created, gas that can be sold, hopefully for a profit.
What we want to demonstrate is that there are alternatives to conventional agriculture of corn and beans.
Sometimes you need to show real-world data before you can convince landowners the benefits of an ecosystem like the prairie.
It truly is a fascinating and far-reaching idea, but getting farmers to buy into it all, especially because of the cost, is the big challenge, ladies. But, you know, I think Rudy's a go-getter. I think that they can make it all happen.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And it's called prairie restoration. There's any idea of how much flooding it can actually reduce?
The exact amount on reducing flooding is still a little iffy, but early indications are that even a thin strip of prairie grass around some of the farm fields at the right places can reduce the runoff by as much as six to eight inches of rainfall. That's not insignificant. So, you know, you put that and you put it elsewhere and you spread it out, there is a chance that it could have a big impact.
Sounds promising.
It does. Four more years of research there.
All right.
No more rain. That's a good thing about us. We had plenty of rain. They could have used some of that prairie grass to protect the runoff from this latest rainfall. Look at the numbers here. Down south, that's where the heaviest ended up. 1 to 3 inches of rain from Salem, Missouri, through Ironton, down into St. Francis, St. Genevieve.